From the award-winning creators of Golf Club Nostalgia and High Water, The Cub has you parkouring your way through the remains of humanity as a child being hunted by the ultra-rich, while a whimsical end-of-days radio show plays tunes and stories to keep you company. Sit back as I take you on the journey through the first 30 minutes of the game. My aim is to give you an unbiased look at the game without the worry of major spoilers and in a super chill format. Later in the video, I'll share my opinion on a number of aspects of the game so far. So grab a cup of tea, get comfy, sit back, and I hope you'll enjoy. Oh no, panicked. Right, let's get on with it then, shall we? New game. Let's go. Very pretty. Oh, doesn't look like it's full damage. Now it's too quiet. Need more granularity on the audio, please, devs. Jump. So he's jumped. Yep. Yeah. Okay. Hold for a stronger jump. Nice. RT to push and pull objects. Whee! That was cool. Oh, what's that? Oh, indeed. What's going on? Oh, okay. Oh, that's the radio thing, right? Okay, cool. Right, so these little yellow handles. Press A and hold left to jump from the edge. Cool. Oh, what's this? That sign is telling me that's death down there. Okay. There you go. Cool. Just keep on running. Look at that. Visuals are very cool. I like this foreground effect. It's very Limbo vibes, you know? If you like Limbo, I'm sure you're going to like this. Ooh.
The days were hot. Fish died in the lake. Plants yellowed. Birds stopped singing. There was thunder, but no rain. You call this period the Great Ecological Catastrophe. I heard my mother's heartbeat as she carried me to Alphaville. People chased us. I remember her driving and bison running by. Then we reached the flooded city with refugees in rubber boats. Suddenly, I couldn't find Mama. I was scared and alone. I'll never know whether she died or abandoned me. I only remember the rockets leaving for Mars. That night, the fighting started. I ran deep into the forest. A she-wolf found me and raised me with her cubs. People who didn't make it into the rockets were dying in combat and from the mutating environment. But we, the orphans and animals, didn't fight. Instead, together we adapted to nature that grew out of the rubble. Many moons passed, and then one day, some humans returned. They called themselves Martians. They flew around, dressed in yellow. They went hunting and played golf. I would steal their golf balls for fun. It really upset them. Then one day, I found a dead Martian. I took off his helmet and put it on. There was music playing in it. After years of only speaking wolf, I listened to the Martian radio and learned human language again. After the group left, one full moon later, I was chasing a tasty bug when another spaceship with new Martians arrived. It soon became clear they were trouble.
Okay. Interesting. Son of No One. Ah, I guess it's just a chapter thing, right? So maybe that was prologue and this is chapter one or something? Did he just sniff his feet? Oh, always go back, children. You never know what you might find. Wait a second. We're missing something there. I thought there was there was some text that come up then. I thought that was there was voices for it, but there you go. Jump. There we go. Oh. Well, that was weird. Oh, okay. It automatically jumped over there. Okay. Got it. Got it. I think the little arrow down in the bottom left there is a save thing. Oh, that didn't sound very friendly. Whoa, no, 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 no. No. I'm not playing with you, Mr. Snake. So the tasty bug is telling me where to go. Oops. No, there's no fall damage. Let's confirm that, shall we? Is there full damage? No. Sorry, that made me jump. There we go. I'm going to stop using the button underneath the controller because it's making me look bad. Okay, maybe it's not the button that's making me look bad. Maybe it's me. Right, let's try this again. Jump, 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 jump. There we go. Ooh. Oh, cool spaceship. Alphaville, that's the city. Okay. Oh, hope we get to go there. Ooh, go backwards, kids. Always go backwards. The devs haven't left us anything, so yeah. What were you thinking, devs? Right, okay. Oh, hello. He's got spikies. That looks like death over there. So I drop down, jump up onto that ledge if I can. Yeah, see that. Oh! Made it.
Starting off the show with Son of No One, a song I'm fairly certain resonates with many of us orphans of the earth out here in the stuffy depths of space. Speaking of stuffy air, please don't attempt to open portal windows to let some fresh air in. It's unbelievable that we have to mention this, but we're living in pressurized domes, people. Breathing recycled air is just the new normal. In totally unrelated news, the memorial of Baroness von Bullenship will be held in private, and her family asks gold diggers and paparazzi to respectfully stay away from the funeral ceremony held in the Section C cafeteria on deck 3 at 7
p.m. Oh no, I didn't mean to go.
All right, I'm at the show.
Oh. Oh wait, what am I supposed to do now?
There's one just there. Made it. Oh, that was quite intense. Oh, I can't go that way. Wait, what? Ah, died. Okay. So drop down here. Run up there. Jump. Jump up there. Jump. Run. Jump. Slide. Jump. Run. Slide. Jump. Get up there. Okay, he doesn't fire at me there. Oh no! Panicked. So I'm guessing I have to go up into that column up there. So let's try that. Come on, come on. There we go. So we jump up to there. Wait for him to go away. Trigger that one. Jump up there. You gonna kill me there? Nope. Where do I go from here then? Oh, it's there. I can see it. Ooh, that's shiny up there. Okay. So, be careful, Mo. Why to interact? Did I just... But what? Interact with this one? Ooh! Renowned Alpha Phil Post. Investigative journalist is missing. Alpha Phil Post. Okay. Oh, this is... collectibles. Didn't see that coming. We got spikes down there. Look, that also looks like death down there. There we go. Made it. Oh no, come on, game. Right. Yeah. Oh no. Okay. I thought I was going to blow up on that mine then. Ooh, let's go. Ooh. Alright, okay. Is there anything up here that I missed? Can I get up that way? Can I go over that way? And I can go up that... Oh, what's that? More food.
Ah, a little toddler popper taking us back to the days of late-stage capitalism at its finest. Child labour never sounded so sweet. On that note, it's time for another story, a look back at life on the open road, and a look forward to the long road ahead.
So, there was music. Is the music gone? Okay. No.
Crying while riding a Harley Davidson.
Okay.
I'm serious. I tried to recreate feeling here on Mars.
Oh no. Choices have been made.
I took the Tesla City Delivery EVA for a spin on the Planitia Plains. But it's like driving a janky VR simulation. It made me miss riding my motorcycle, my Jolene, even more.
At 35, for 30 days in the blistering heat of July, I took a 4,600-mile trip across America on my motorbike. We set off from California, we zigzagged up and down the country, and covered 18 states all the way up to New York City, where I was to take over my father's company. During the trip, the biggest surprise for me was how much of my thinking was practical. Even banal, I just focused on staying alive at 70 miles an hour on two wheels with crazy winds buffeting me in all directions. So while my mind was this constant barrage of compulsive thoughts, those thoughts were generally practical. Like, how do I get to that destination before dark? Am I drinking enough water? Am I hydrating? The bigger picture stuff of why am I doing this and what is life about anyway didn't come until later.
What's that?
Started the trip at the peak of California's infamous heat wave, and we rode it for 5 days in temperatures you wouldn't believe. Some mornings I'd have sweat dripping from my elbows before we even set off. My eyes hurt from the sun. Sometimes I'd wake up so sore I could barely move. My inner thighs had engine burn. And even though those closest to me actually didn't think I'd make it, I learned that I could physically overcome much more than I thought. So after that rite of passage, I knew I could take over the company. Instead of being an entitled little brat whose father would pay for her theater career, I turned the company into a $1 trillion business. And now, here I am with my family on Mars, among the last representatives of humanity in the universe.
Okay,
but
I didn't
aside
want...
from this high-minded idealism,
there's more.
Life has no meaning. Because of these damn EVA suits, there's no wind on the highway here. No open air solitude that makes you feel one with the world like back on Earth. On Mars, even if you manage to get outside, you're still trapped in a bubble of your own stale air. No matter where you go, isolation clings to you. Unlike the open road, it's an experience of void, not wholeness. There's no dancing asphalt in the heat, and no neon-lit diners and 2 a.m. omelets with green bell peppers and yellow cheddar with a side of burnt hash browns, greasy bacon and black coffee. Instead, there's this barren rock and strictly monitored oxygen levels in sterile domes. We live in bubbles within bubbles. I admire how far we've come and how resilient we are, but I wonder, maybe we're just fooling ourselves. Just like during my epic ride, we've mostly figured out the banal questions about water and food and sanitation, and now the greater questions are looming. What are we really doing here? What is our future? And what will the meaning of life be for my kids?
Okay.
The point is, I miss my Jolene. That's all.
Is that
Thanks
all? I didn't have a choice.
Thank you for taking us on that ride.
I mean,
Rihanna, your story is an inspiration for all. And
it's a radio and I get it.
Head on and to value the small things in life, even out here.
But how am I supposed to read that whilst the radio's going on?
Grease, wind in the hair. What better way to remember than with some psychedelic rock for the road?
Radio Nostalgia from Mars.
Okay. So you have crashed in a hostile territory near the suspected enemy bunker. Closest allies are 15 clicks west, estimating you have approximately 17 minutes to reach the safe distance. Alphaville is 100 clicks east. It's USB, okay. Now there's music. You got music now.
Yay!
Oops. Double jump. Can I go up that way? No, I can't. Ah! Pushed me all the way back. Ah! There we go. I made that harder work than it needed to be. Oh, a crocodile in the foreground. Oh, hello. He doesn't seem very happy. Oh, we're getting near to town now. We're near to the city. Okay, so we've got one of these dudes. Wait, what? Oh my god! I thought I could go underneath then. Oh man, how am I supposed to get over that? Right, let's look at this carefully. So we've got water thing there. It doesn't look like I can get under it. And then there's spikes the other side. Oh, he got me. It's all about the timing. What we've got going on here? Oh. Woohoo! Let's go. Off of it, make sure I get hooked on. Okay, spiky's there.
Home away from home.
Ambushed. Ambushed by insurgents, managed to retreat and regroup.
Skies, warm days, the long lost sun.
3 KIA, 2 MIA. There is no drinking water in the regions controlled by the insurgents. On our way back to Alphaville in time for the Hope mission.
We're safe here on Mars. We are the Alpha and Omega of humanity. With the aid of Omis, of course.
Oh, what's this?
In a can.
There's nothing there. Right, there is one thing I'm going to have to do. It's a shame, because the radio is a key part of the game. But you can't filter out the music separate from the radio. So I want to focus on the in-game things, and it's quite difficult to do that when you've got the radio going in your ear. So we're just going to do this. Continue game. There you go. I guess you could put your own radio on. Ooh, hello. Play your own music sort of thing, I suppose. It's a shame because I really like the voiceover and the stories. Right, jump. Ooh, I can swim. Remember kids, always go back on yourself. You never know what the developers might hide. Nothing. Okay. Ooh. Thank you for the slight little warning there. Appreciate you. Right, so I'm guessing you have to go through here. Yeah, look at that. Try not to get spiked. I want to go back this way actually, because there is a hint of going this way. There you see, there we go. Thank you, devs. Orinoco's CEO, Jeff Bozo. Oh, I love that. That's brilliant. Says AlphaVille bound delivery supplies disrupted by insurgents. That's well done. Oh dear. Right. Symbiosis announces its GMO formula solves world hunger. Jeff Bozo. Oh dear. Oops. Okay, that was luck more than judgment. Oh, hello. Oh, that was close. I mean, it's going to make me go up there, isn't it? Nope. I think, again, that was more luck than judgement. Is it Ark over on the right there? Oh. Can I duck then? I guess I can I? Yes, I can. They don't look very friendly, so I think ducking it's probably a good move. Okay. Right, next one. So you can't look further forward, so the view's static. So I'm gonna have to go into no. It's definitely this way. It's got to be this way. Can I get up that way? Go up this way. Let's see what we got up here. Oh no. Go down. Okay. So go careful when you go left. Because there may be death. Right, so we've got there. Do that. Do that. Oh no. I'm going to keep going this way because it's this. Oh. I don't know if you can climb up from the ropes. Should we do some science on that one? Yes, you can. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. There we go. Ah! I keep forgetting you've got a double jump to get to those tree branches, or a long jump at least. Oh, this time we're going to do it, all right? Come up here, do that. There we go. Now where? There we go. Which way is it? This way. Uh-oh, we're in danger. Ah, there's a leap of faith right there. Another leap of faith. I mean, those clothes are quite big. Oh, hello. What have we got here? Why to interact? Oh, Rudyard Kipling. The Jungle Book. Huh. Oh, the strength of the pack is the wolf. And the strength of the wolf is the pack. Very cool. Very cool. Thank you for sharing your inspiration with us. Very cool. Right, Charlie, I wish you the best of luck on your flight to Mars. And thank you for your kind invitation. All those people, members of the Alphaville board and their families, count on your piloting skills. Look at you, a real hero. But I won't be joining the Hope mission. Instead, I'm back in my mountain house. Unlike you, my stargazing friend. I'm an earthling through and through. I'll stay put. Wouldn't miss this terrestrial show for anything in the world. Bon voyage, mon ami. Pete. Ah. Can hear chickens. Okay. Press RT to push and pull the objects. Oh, okay. Let's push this in. I'm guessing it wants me to push it over this way somewhere. Oh, that's cool. Let's escape it. Okay, so there's the first 30 minutes of the game, The Cub, which is available on PC, PS5, PS4 and Switch. The visual style of this game is great, and it's what drew me to it. The foreground and background dynamic, although not original, are done really well in The Cub. The audio in this one is a little bit tricky. I really like the ambient sounds and I love the narration, but I struggle to read when I have music in my ears. So the effect of the radio causes me to stop whenever I need to read something. You can turn the radio off or down, but I feel that takes away from what the devs intended. Let me know what you think below. I use an Xbox controller on this one and it works great. Not a lot to worry about here. The game is very responsive. Platformers usually take me down a path of immense fun, or I'm ready to throw my controller in the sea. Although I only played for about 30 minutes, I feel this balance was pretty good. Was it fun? Yes. I'm not so sure. Not because it's a bad game or anything, but there are so many other games competing for people's time right now that this one will probably drop down the priority list. Let me know in the comments below if you'd like to see more, and I'll do another video. Anyway, thanks for watching. Take care. Bye. I'm going to keep going this way.